last class we were discussing about the generation of voltage in AC machines, where by rotating the field structure at a given speed, you would get a voltage generated in the armature. And we got the we can consider a typical synchronous generator like this, where you have three phases A, B and C, and this is the field winding, F winding, which will rotate at omega electrical radians per second. When it rotates at omega electrical radians per second, it will induce a voltage of omega electrical radians per second, or frequency, which is omega by 2 pi. And the therefore, to produce a given frequency, you must run at a given speed. And that speed is 2 pi f electrical radians per second, or that omega electrical radians is also equal to omega divided by p by 2 mechanical radians. So it is always 314 radians per second for 50 hertz, because 2 pi f is 314, or which is equal to 3000 rpm. So it's always 3000 rpm electrical, which would mean 1500 rpm mechanical for 4 pole and so on. Okay. Now the most important thing is for if you freeze this structure on a given field structure, then with reference to it will, if supposing this is the position of the field, let us say this is the position of the field, which will means where will be my B max, what position the B max would be, along which axis? No, along this field axis. So it will always be along the field axis, but while the field, since the field axis is moving, that B max point may change. Therefore, at this given point, when it is frozen at this point, let me keep it stationary, then B max will be with reference to this a zero, that means at this axis, this is with reference to field axis. Okay, so this is the F axis. So this is the F axis point. Okay, now F axis point, you have the B max, right, with this F axis point, we get the B max. Then as you move away from that axis, then the B will come to zero at 90 degrees from the axis. Then it will go to minus B max when it goes to the south pole. Okay, this is the north pole and south pole, and comes like this. So this will go through this cycle. Obviously, the total flux per pole, that means whatever is the total flux that this pole is giving, will be, you have to integrate over, let's say, minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 in this case. Okay, and when you do this, the minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 B into theta d theta, that will be equal to the average B over the pole surface, average B over the pole surface into the area of the pole, which is, and that we called it as the phi max. So phi max is therefore flux per pole. Is the flux okay? That is the flux that is equal to what we derived yesterday. No, this is the phi max is total flux per pole. Yes, B average into a pole area. Okay, and that we have derived an expression. But we have another picture here, another waveform here. Now, this is the how the flux is linking, let us say, A phase. So, it will go with reference to A, supposing if this is the A axis, as this is spinning, now, with omega t, or with theta, it will have a maximum flux linking when the F axis is aligned with A axis. When the F axis or the field axis aligned with A axis at that instant, then the A winding will have the maximum flux linking it. When the two axes are same, all the flux will be linking that coil. If you have a coil, supposing this is the coil, let's say A dash, and you place the pole here, north pole, south pole. Okay, now all the flux will be linking, right? That is the instant. That means this is the axis, F axis, which is also same as A axis. This is one extreme, one case. And you can take another case where you place like this, right? Because what is our flux linkage formula is between this point to this point, what is B d theta? Okay? After all, this is creating a B over theta, so B d theta from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. But in this case, what is happening? It is A dash, okay? Between this point to this point, whatever is the total flux that is linking, right? So this will become, this is flux is equal to 0. Here the flux is equal to phi max. Okay, this is two extreme cases where theta is equal to 0 degrees and here theta is equal to 90 degrees. Where theta is the angle in the field axis and the armature axis. Yes, for A phase. For A phase only. For B phase, C phase, it will go later after 120 degrees. Okay? So, this is the two extreme cases. How you can create, you put a pole, if the A is fixed, you put a pole here and maximum flux is linking, you put a pole here, zero flux is linking. Okay? In between, it will have a sinusoidal variation since we assume B to be sinusoidally varying in space. Is it clear? So, this coil, stationary coil, will experience different flux linkages at different instants of time, and because it experiences different flux linkages, the voltage will be d lambda by dt. That will also go through a sinusoidal variation. Okay, the flux linkage and the voltage will be shifted by 90 degrees. So we have seen, if this is the lambda, is a cosine curve with reference to, this is a theta. Theta is now the position of the F axis with reference to A axis at any instant of time. And that goes on changing. Theta will be equal to omega t. Isn't it? Assuming theta is equal to omega t, assuming that time t equal to 0, theta equal to 0. That means at time t equal to 0, a field axis is aligned with A axis. If it is any arbitrary angle delta, it will be theta is equal to omega t plus delta. Is that clear? So that is at initial instance, you assume that your field is somewhere placed here like this, along the A axis. Then it goes on changing. So it is at this instant, it is at arbitrary angle theta. Okay? Theta is, this is the angle theta, that is the field axis with reference to A axis. It is going round in this manner. Okay? So, you have the flux linkage of A phase with like this, and obviously the derivative of this is the voltage. That means d lambda, this is lambda, d lambda by dt will be like this, is minus sign. Okay? So, this is the basic that you should, any doubt on this? So, we assume that you know that there is a sinusoidal voltage induced in the A phase, and the RMS value of voltage, we derived an expression last class. So we said that ERMS is given by 4.44 F into number of turns. I will call it as number of series turns NSE into phi max, where F is the frequency is equal to omega by 2 pi, which is also equal to omega mechanical by, where will be my omega electric, this is omega electrical, right? And it is, where do I put my P by 2? And this is omega mechanical is equal to RPM. You see, N is the RPM, NS. So what is it? It is 2 pi NS by 60. So F is equal to 2 pi NS by 2 pi. No, actually it is not. It is P by 2, is it? Yeah. P by 2 into P by 2. So, what is the frequency equal to? So, frequency of generated voltage will be? Huh? What is the simplification of this? Huh? So, 120, NP by 120. The number of, that is, synchronous speed. So, NS is the synchronous speed in RPM. Okay? Now, in the other, that is the frequency. Now, we define SE is number of series turns per phase. The NSE is the number of series turns per phase. That means how many turns you are placing in this coil, A phase. So there are 100 turns, 200 turns, 300 turns, or one turn, depending upon this. So it is a coil made up of certain turns, but they are all connected in series. So you have NSE is number of series turns per phase. And phi max is flux per pole, because that is the maximum flux that can link. And that is related to what? How do you can you change the flux per pole? Can you change the flux per pole in an AC generator? Changing the field current. This relates to field current. So, you increase the field current, you can change the flux per pole. Okay? So, that is one way. That means the voltage related to what?
Voltage generated in AC generator
would therefore be related to frequency,
which in turn related to the speed of rotation, related to number of turns. If you increase the number of turns, but when the machine is made, you can't do much about it because already the number of turns are placed already. This is a design parameter.
Now, you have the same thing if you consider this A phase, then the same thing happened to B and C phases after 120 degrees as you spin it, okay, rotating. Therefore, we can write now, this is same for all phases. This is important. So, you say
either A phase or B phase or C phase,
the
ERMS is same. Okay.
And therefore, you can say EA is root 2 times ERMS. Let us say into, let us say if you write it as cos omega t, then EB would be root 2 times ERMS. What will be the B phase?
Instantaneously.
Cos omega t minus 120. And EC will be root 2 ERMS. Cos omega t plus 120. So you get a 3 phase voltage. So we get 3 phase voltage. Maximum value is root 2 ERMS. Right? Right, EB and EC. The peak value of EA is here. So, the EB will be, peak value of EB will be somewhere here. That is after 120 degrees. So, then similarly you will have EC. So that will be around this is 30. So you write EA, EB, EC like this. They will be phase shifted by 120. So you get 3 phase voltages. So we now know a three-phase generator, whether it is AC synchronous machine, then the field is rotating. Because that happens in induction machine also, because there also the field is rotating in the air gap. So that will induce three-phase voltages which will oppose the supplied voltage. Okay. So in synchronous and asynchronous machines, three-phase voltages are induced in the armature windings.
Yes.
In an induction machine, you are applying a three-phase voltage, okay, and it produces a three-phase field. So, as far as the stator windings are concerned, they will also be interacting with these three-phase fields. So, a voltage is induced in the windings. So, that is like a E, like a back EMF. So, voltage is induced, which opposes the applied voltage. The difference between them may at most be the impedance drops, stator resistance and so on, okay. So there will always, otherwise if there is no opposing voltage, the whole voltage, it becomes like a very heavy current will flow. Okay? So there will always be an opposing voltage in induction machine, which will oppose the applied voltage. Okay? Now, these expressions are true for how I have placed in each phase, it is a concentrated winding. Only one coil is there per phase. Okay, and that is what is the angle between the coil sides? 180 degrees. Okay, now supposing you have a not 180 degrees, let us say a short pitched winding. That means you don't place it here. You place it at some angle, otherwise it would have been maybe AA dash. This angle is, let us say this angle is beta. That means it is not, a coil is not made of 180 degrees, but by some other angle. Then what will you get? A coil is made, but it is placed in a different slot, okay, which is not at a slot here, maybe one slot or two slots before that, okay. And this is deliberately done. We'll find out how and why. Now, what is the, if the earlier the voltage, okay, now let us, I have drawn it here. So, of course, these are the three voltages, EA, EB, EC, and the phasors, which is very clear.
That diagram, beta is something else.
Which one? Yeah, beta is as the angle by which it is less than 180 degrees. It is same. Pardon?
Bottom right, I think, on that.
Which one?
No,
it is actually a... It is wrongly written. It is this. It is the angle between. It is this angle only. The angle between.
Subtended at the center or subtended at the other?
No, it is subtended at the center. Okay, but this is slightly wrongly drawn. Now, it is not 180 degrees. It is just less than 180 degrees. Okay, now. If it was 180 degrees, then whatever voltage is in, voltages here and here would be same. But they would be at the same instant. Okay? At the two coil sides, one is at north pole, other is south pole. So, the voltage will be, voltage E1 and voltage, let us say E2, they would be in phase. if you do it early, then they will experience a phase shift. Okay, this voltage will not be in phase, they will be phase shifted by an angle beta. Okay, and therefore there will be a voltage across cell A1 and A3, that's 1 and 2, which is short corded, would therefore be the vectorial sum of E1 and E2, but E2 being not in phase with E1. Okay. You see, there is a coil side which is at 180 degrees. Now, the total voltage will be voltage in one coil side plus voltage in the other coil side. And this, when this is under the influence of north pole, this will be under the influence of south pole. Okay, but their angle, if you even say BLV, one is moving this way, another is moving the other way. Okay, therefore the voltage will be same. So if this is 100 volts here, this will be 100 volts here, total is 200 volts. But here it is not 200 volts, it will be 100 volts here, another 100 volts, but not at 180 degrees, but at some other angle beta. Okay. Okay. I think you can see this this picture. Now, otherwise you are getting the voltage is same. This is E1 and this is E2 and this was the total voltage. Okay. Now, the second one is now shifted by an angle beta. Right. Now, your voltage now is OC and not OB. Is it clear? In this one, the new voltage in a short corded is OC and not OB. That means it is not twice E. Okay. Is it clear? So, yeah, that means earlier you are having both these in phase, like E1 is phase, but now you have this voltage and another one is at another angle, at angle beta. So, these two voltages are, this is sine wave and this another sine wave, this is shifted by angle beta. So, total voltage would have been this if they were in phase. This is the total voltage. That means it would have been double of this only. But now it is shifted by some other angle. So you will get a third value OC. So if you look this picture, let us say we define a factor KD, distribution factor. Sorry. We call it as pitch factor. Pitch factor KD is voltage in corded winding . This is also called cord, this is short pitched or corded. I mean, this is a term used. It is called, it is not 180 degrees, and voltage in corded winding over voltage in full pitch winding. Right? Now, this is a factor. Now, by geometrically, because you can always see that is, this will be, how much will it be this? So, this is beta by 2, this is beta by 2. So, that is, if you just take a say, if you take this, what will be this equal to? OC is equal to 2E cos beta. So, we can write like this. Voltage in corded winding is twice E cos beta by 2. But if it was full pitch, 2E. So, this will be cos beta by 2. So this is the factor KD. So what will be ERMS in this case? Why did it get a term cos beta by 2? Because this is equal to 2e cos beta by 2. Is it okay? Voltage in carded winding, that is in this case OC by OB. Okay? Okay? OC by OB, that's what it is. So ERMS is what now? The voltage ERMS will now be equal to 4.44 F. The KD, KP. Not KP. It is pitch factor. Please change it. It is the pitch factor KP is cos beta by 2. Okay. Now, the voltage will be 4.1 F into KP NSC into 5X because you have to multiply with this factor cos beta by 2. Okay. Now, you have another thing that happens, which is you don't have only one coils in each phase. You have several coils in each phase. So, what do you call that winding as? Distributed winding. It's not concentrated. So, next is if you have a distributed winding, okay, if you have distributed winding, what will happen? See, we have seen in what is distribution, instead of having one coil, what will you do? You have in a distribution, you put more coils. So, you will have A1, A2, A3, A1 dash, A2 dash, A3 dash. I mean, I think we have done this earlier. Instead of 300 turns putting in only two slots, I distribute 100 and put it in successive slots so it becomes a phase belt. So, this is a phase belt. Then what do you expect here? Not the three cos beta. You see, that means you can consider that this is one coil, this is another coil, this is a third coil, but the voltage in all the three will now be phase shifted by an angle, supposing the angle is alpha. Okay? Alpha is the slot angle. Then you would expect what? So, earlier you would have gone E, E and E, okay? If it is all in the same phase, all in the same slots. So, now what you will have, so E, this will bend by an alpha, okay? This another bend by another alpha. So, this is the, okay? This magnitude, of course, will be E, but there will be phase shift by here by one alpha, another by another alpha. So, net voltage will be, let us say, O, OA and maybe an OC or whatever it is. It is not short pitch. It is not short pitch at all. It's full pitch, but distributed. So these two are different. Yes?
Is this angle alpha the same as the mechanical angle of separation?
Two slots. Yeah, but this alpha is electrical degrees. Okay?
So it will not be same as a mechanical actual separation. It will be only two-pole machine.
Ha, two-pole machine it will be. Suppose, that means if the angle is 30 degrees, 15 degrees, 30 degrees mechanical, then it will be 60 degrees electrical if it's four-pole or something like that. Okay? Because in mechanical, one rotation is always 360 degrees mechanical. But if it is electrical, it is 720 for four-pole. Okay? And it's 360 only for two pole. Yeah. Now, how do you, that means we distribute another fact. This is we have another called a KD, which is OC by OA. This is called distribution factor. Distribution factor is, what is the magnitude OC, because they are shifted by OA. No, because this is the voltage in the first one, supposing this is E, second coil will lag by alpha, third will lag another by alpha. Okay, so that will go on shifting. If it is another one, it will go like this. Okay, so you have right. So now you have these three coils. Of course, you can connect them in series. Okay, A1, A1 dash, A2, A2 dash, A3, A3. Three coils are in series. So you have three voltages, EA1, EB1, EA1, EA2, EA3, shifted by alpha. Is it clear? So these are the So that means you have A1, A2, A3, A1 dash, A2 dash, A3 dash. So first you go through one coil, shift to the second coil, shift to the third coil, come out. So you have the total E, which is all the three coils voltages together. Okay, I think this, now that means as we have done, so this will be EA1, EA2 and EA3, and this will be ED. So in this figure we would like to know AD. Okay, now the best thing is you take the perpendicular bisector of all these four, this and the total. Okay, pardon? Why? Yeah, they incidentally meet at a point. I don't know. Okay, the permanent bisector of this and this and this, as well as this whole thing, also meets at the same point. Okay? And the angle subtended here in this case is 3 alpha. Okay? This is alpha plus alpha plus alpha. Okay? And right, any doubts on this? No. You take the perpendicular bisector of all this 1, 2, 3 and AD also. They are not perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular bisectors. They are not, maybe it is, drawing is not very clear, but Pardon?
AO is perpendicular to AB, not that bisector.
Who said that? See, this is supposed to be perpendicular bisector. Okay. What is? No, this is just a you from the point O you meet OA, OB, OC, OD. Okay. Now what is AD in terms of OA?
So what is OA?
Just a minute. Just a minute. Okay. KD is from that figure. AD divided by, let us say, 3 times AB. Okay. The total, if it were concentrated with 3 times AB. Okay. Please concentrate at this point. Now, AD is the net voltage if it is a distributed winding. AD. Now, that AD is in this case you have this is 3 alpha by 2 is this angle, So I sine 3 alpha by 2 is what? You know, this is perpendicular bisector. Okay? And it will be OA into sine 3 alpha by 2. Is it alright? This AD. Okay. So AD is twice into OA sine 3 alpha by 2. Is it alright? Huh? And AB is OA into sine alpha by 2. Twice. Okay? Yeah, this is one, this extending alpha, this is alpha by 2, this is 90 degrees. Actually, it is it's not a very well drawn figure. This is 90 degrees. So, that is OA into this, into sine of this alpha by 2. Okay. Now, in this case, yeah.
So, what is OA?
It's just an arbitrary, this is yeah. No. It is just to sum up, you know, it is a geometrical construction only.
No.
See, geometrically you do it.
How do we get the point O? The
perpendicular bisector of all these 1, 2, 3 and 4, all of them meet at the same point.
So, why is
it a rectangular polygon? See, you have this and this. Will it not meet at one point? And will it not be same? Huh? See, these are same sides. These are same side, I say. Magnitude wise, same. I think your geometric knowledge, you know, is. Hmm? Yeah, time constant is going very bad, I think. You know, yeah. Okay. You make another one. That will also go here. You make another one. So long as these are same sides, same magnitudes, that will also go here. Okay? You try this. Pardon? Uh-huh. Yes.
Why don't we simply take the definition of AD in terms of AD and AD and why go towards, and why try to separate them in terms of O and
O? No, that is basically. See, I am trying to get at a. Okay, now all I want is to get a KD. Okay, so KD is AD is twice YA sine 3 alpha by 2 over twice YA. So that is twice OA gets cancelled. That is here sine 3 alpha by 2 over 3 times sine alpha by 2. Where alpha is slot angle in electrical degrees. Slot angles in electrical degrees. And now you have here what is 3? Here 3 is slots per pole per phase. These are how many slots per pole per phase. That means let M be the slot per pole per phase. Supposing we have, in this case it is 3, it could be anything. It could be 2, 4 or whatever it is. In this case what will be the KD? What, please tell me what is KD if it is, yeah, general formula of a KD will be sine M alpha by 2 over M sine alpha. Yeah, this will always less than 0.95 or something like that. Okay. Now, therefore, we call KW as KP KD. That is called winding factor. You remember we defined with, you know, earlier when MMF calculation, we defined a term called KW. So that means instead of N, it becomes KWN. So what will be the ERM? m is, if it is distributed, it will be 4.44 f into kd nse into phi max. Okay, but if it is both short pitched and distributed, then you have kw. So for both, that means short coordinate. Pardon? Yeah, kp was when it was only pitch concentrated winding. Short pitch concentrated. You can make this one a dash not at 180, it could be less also. You can make this whole bunch come nearer by angle beta.
Now, what is the use of having a short pitch winding, sir?
Yeah, that we'll see later. What is the use? After all, engineers are not supposed to do anything which is useless. Okay. So, but people are mad and they do it like that. Okay. Let's see why they are doing it. So, ERMS. Okay. So, it is 4.44. Okay. So, you now know that there is a winding factor Kw, and which has to be, that means don't use NSE now, multiply by a winding factor. Then all your, so in all the windings, so you multiply, this is Kw NSE is called effective turns. So there will be Kp, Kd, which is Kw, etc. So now the question is asked, why do we do this? That answer I can only give next class. Okay? Why we do all this? Because, you know, if it is both short coordinate and distributed,